What's up guys, welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to talk about the Durango and the new tires that were installed and how freaking awesome they look. Let's get to it. So we're back again and it's a little dirty. Needs to be cleaned. Hasn't been cleaned in a little while, which is always my fault, of course. I still need to get these wheels touched up. All four of the outer lips on the barrels are chafed or rashed. Some of them are worse than others, as like this one is. But if you guys remember the last time I did a video, I talked about the tires and I finally upgraded them. So now we have, or it has 305, 35, 22s all the way around. Before they were 285 40s. Not only do 305, 35, 22s equate to the factory overall diameter of the 20 inch wheel, so fuel economy is no longer an issue, which it always was to begin with. I mean, I probably average 21, 22 at best. On the highway. Typically it's like high teens, 19, 20 mostly, but it was a lot lower than that. The average was like 17, 16 on the 285 40s. So with the 305 35s, everything went back to factory. Your speedometer is no longer affected. It's back to factory. But the overall stance of this thing with the 305s now, super freaking beefy. If you ask me, wheels are still the same, obviously, but the fact that you have a nice tire on there. These are 305, 35, 22s. These are the LionHart LH-Five tire, and they are a 110W XL rating, which is fine. I'm not tracking this, but they are extremely quiet tires compared to the Bridgestone tires that were on this when I got it, which are the factory 20 inch Bridgestone tires. These things are freaking loud. But these, yeah, these are nice and I approve. Now the ones I had before, the 285 40s, those were a Lexani LX20 or LX25, I can't remember what those were. Those are a nice tire, but I like the LionHarts. For one, they're not really that expensive. The complete set were just shy of 900 bucks, which is pretty good for a set of 22 inch tires. But the poke in the front, that's dead on, straight view. You'll see straight front and rear. But boy, oh boy, it's wide and aggressive. Next thing I want to do is put a front lip and the rock protector guards on the front, the rock protector guards on the back of the fender there. I might want to do some side skirts, we'll see. And I definitely want to do the SRT fender flares. I've been told by a couple people that it does work. You don't really have to modify anything. And then I've been told by a couple other people that you have to remove the side skirts, the rear bumper, pretty much everything to convert to SRT for them to work. So I'm gonna do a little research on that for you Durango people out there, Durango owners that is, that might have done that. Let me know if it was hard to do, if you have done it, or if you know anybody who've done it. There you go, guys. Really, really nice deep tread blocks. Initially, when I saw the tire, I thought to myself it's gonna be loud, but they're not. They're pretty quiet. Real quick update for you guys. Next time you see it, for one, it'll be clean. And maybe it has different wheels. I'm kind of leaning towards getting a set of Velgans or Velgan. Can't really remember how to pronounce that. The classic fives, version two. We'll see. I really, really want to do bronze on this, but the wife's saying no. Drop your comments down below, let me know. I also did get the front windshield tinted. I don't know if I updated you guys on that or not, but 35% front windshield, 5% all the way around. I need to find an overlay kit for this to smoke that out. The taillight smoke kit I have is from Lux Auto. So if you guys know where to find that, let me know.